Get ready to match the star, Scoey Mitchell, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Manny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, John, how are you? Are you all ready to have more fun and games? Okay, they're ready. Are you ready?
That is really incredible.
Thank you.
Pretty.
Are you all ready for fun and games?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that nice piece.
Me handsome.
Nice piece of threads you're wearing there. Very fancy.
Gorgeous.
Isn't that neat?
Yeah.
It's
a
bar mitzvah suit.
Yes.
Let's say hello to Tom Parker and Susan Stewart. Tom has $5,700.
Fantastic.
And he's very happy about that. He's being challenged by Susan here, who had her first and second round questions, right?
Right.
And she's matched three of our celebrities, and she's got her fingers crossed, and he's got his fingers crossed. She's hoping he doesn't, and he's hoping he does. Well, will he or won't he? We'll find out after this. All right. No. Here we go. Tom, you know what you have to do? Three to tie, four to win. Here we go.
Okay.
Fred said.
Tom is still with us, huh?
Tom is still with us, yes. Fred said that. Tom is still with us. It says right here. Fred said Tom is still with us. Now, he said, that country I visited was strange. When they sing their national anthem, they don't put their hands over their hearts. They put them over their blanks.
I'm ready.
Good. Scoey's ready.
Don't think too hard.
No. Oh, no. Right. I don't want to break my
All head. Right. All right, Tom Parker, think carefully, and here it is. Fred said, that country I visited was strange. When they sing their national anthem, they don't put their hands over their hearts. They put them over their blanks.
Their bottoms.
Their bottoms. Okay. He's been watching the show.
What did he say?
He said their bottoms.
I don't even know why I asked, because I knew it wasn't what I wrote.
What did you write?
I wrote, they put them over their heads.
Over their heads, that's good. Okay.
Yes, darling.
You play.
Just a minute here. Oh, say can you see buns?
Buns. Okay, John. You picked up a pair. Charles?
Better start smoking.
Again?
I said mouse because it's such a lousy tune.
Yeah, that's right.
What did he say?
He said it's an impossible song to sing, and it is in many ways. Someone should revise it. A friend of mine tried to get an act of Congress once. He rewrote it in a very singable good way. Paul Taubman did that, and Congress turned him down. Isn't that interesting?
It is interesting because it's a very...
What do you do? And this the rockets, a... red glare. That's a part you can't sing about. That's what we're talking about.
Are we talking about...
You know, when you're going to
this
relate...
This is my time, Scully!
Now, wait a minute. Sit down.
All right.
I'm allowing him to make
then
a statement.
Then let him say my answer, because I don't want to say it.
All right, say your answer.
All right, I'll do it myself. Mouth!
Uh-oh. That means you have to match the two remaining ones, Tom, to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
What is the question?
I've forgotten. Let me read it again. Fred said that country I visited was strange. When they sing their national anthem, they don't put their hands over their hearts. They put them over their...
ears.
Ears. So that means Susan Stewart wins the game. Thank you, Harry. She said she's surprised. Well, I thought bottoms up would come up a little more frequently than they did, but it didn't, Tom. But anyway, I'm glad you're not leaving empty-handed because you look like a neat kid.
Thank you very much.
You got $5,700, Tom Parker. Now we got this for you, Susan. You could win over $5,000 here. Are you ready?
No.
Oh, yes, you are. We polled a studio audience here not too long ago, Susan, and we got their best response to this blank form. Now, the answer they gave most frequently is worth a lot of money to you. If you match it, $500. And for matching the second most popular answer, they wrote down on their little cards, you get $250, and then $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist.
Richard.
Something I used on the very first date I had with Brett.
What was that?
Chloroform.
Chloroform. Chloroform, yeah.
Scully.
Maidenform.
Well, I beg your pardon.
Maidenform.
Maidenform. Oh, that's a goodie.
Charles.
What do you have?
Well, I have this. I
He's thinking.
No, I'll go with mine. Conform.
Conform. Conform. So you have maidenform, conform, and chloroform. There's an H in chloroform. Nothing.
And he got to see it.
That's right. Okay, chloroform. There you are. Now, do you want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own?
I think I'll go with maidenform.
I'm mad.
Really?
Chloroform.
You'd like to explain? No, you don't have to. No, we're just looking for maidenform. Let's see if we've got a pair under the $100 response. Order form. That's a business phrase there. Let's see if maiden form is under the $250 number. Racing form.
Oh,
wow.
I
thought of that. What an
audience. Maiden form is the answer that Scoey gave you. And you think it's going to be up on top, audience?
Yeah.
Okay, Earl, may we see it? Yeah!
Very good.
Congratulations. Attaboy, Scoey. Yeah, you got the $500. We add that to the $100. You're going to have $600. You're going to play for $5,000 now. And we're going to give you that money, but you got to match one celebrity first. You have to choose one.
I'm going to stick with Scoey.
Okay, Scoey gets set to write. Stand on the blue dot there, and here we go. Get your ESP flowing over to Scoey, and good luck to you, Susan. Here it is. Blank pork. P-O-R-K. Blank pork. Well, he thought it over very carefully and made a considered decision there. Now, you give us an answer that matches his, and we give you the $5,000. Blank pork.
I can't think of anything.
Blank pork.
Blank pork.
Yes. Oh, I said that. You have to say something else. It's the, I say the blank pork part, and you say you put something in the blank there.
Stuffed. I can't think of anything.
Can't think of anything.
Not a thing, though.
Really? Well, we'll find out right now what Scoey said. She said stuffed pork because she kind of drew a blank on it. It had to say something.
Yeah, it's kind of rough. That's kind of rough. Well, no, I said roast pork.
Roast pork, yes. That's the first thing I thought, a simple, straightforward, direct answer,
Let
roast pork.
Here and do it. And
yes, okay, you take the microphone. I said, ask me now. Ask me
okay,
now.
Now you fill in the blank in.
What?
Blank pork.
Let me see now. Roast pork. All right.
What is the answer?
Roast pork.
I had stuffed.
Oh.
You're crazy. Listen, all that's crazy. You'll be back in a minute or so while you watch this message now. We have a new player. We happily welcome Robin Daytree. How are you, Robin?
Great, thank you.
Before we start the game, we'd like to find out a little bit about you. If you would please tell us the Robin Daytree story as much as you care to contribute.
Well, I'm a Texas girl married to a California guy, and we have a son, Ryan, 9 months old.
And you live in this area somewhere?
Burbank.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Burbank.
I've heard of it, yes. The second network is based over there, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, of course. Anything else you want to contribute?
I'm tickled to death to be here.
Well, we're delighted to have you, Robin. You may have A or B.
A.
A. You sure you want A? You can have B if you'd like. It's up to you. Okay,
A.
She said A. Dumb Donald is so dumb.
I'm so easy.
He went exploring for gas by drilling in a blank. That's how dumb he is. He went exploring for gas by drilling in a blank.
He went exploring
for gas. You know the way they explore for gas.
No, I don't. How do they explore?
Well, they drill a hole in them.
That's oil.
No, they do the gas is the same way. It comes from the earth.
Yes, well, I knew that.
Natural
I didn't know how they went about it.
By drilling in a blank.
By drilling in a... Dumb Donald is so
ready.
I know, the bottom tier is always ready. Oh. All right.
I'm going to have to change my answer.
You going to change?
It's amazing, the amount.
Robin, Dumb Donald is so dumb he went exploring for gas by drilling in a...
Gas tank.
A gas tank.
Car. Gas
All right.
Tank.
She said he went exploring for gas by drilling in a gas tank, and that would be a dumb thing to do.
Yeah, you should follow your first instinct, shouldn't you?
Yes. What did you say first?
I started to say get in the rear of a car, you know.
Yeah.
I said a stove.
In a stove, all right. That's a good choice.
And I wanted to change it because Brett said in a stove, too, after she saw my card.
That's true. I said stove.
You said
and
stove.
And you know I was going to say gas tank, and
I'm sure you were.
But that's dumb, but of course that was the point, wasn't
it? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it was the whole idea. I said Dumb Donald loud and clear.
We have another round to go.
Show him how to play the game.
This is the definitive answer. A beanery.
A beanery. It may be the definitive in your lexicon, but not in mine. Then. He went exploring for gas by drilling in a gas tank. Oh, good. Now, Brett. Put yourself together. Stop that. You're going to get the water all over your head.
It ain't water.
Oh, it ain't water. Without walking flames.
Oh, that's so funny. Yeah. Oh, I love that so much.
Oh, you're right, Charles. Okay. Now, are you ready? Where are we?
Oh, yeah.
I forgot. I lost my place. Dumb Donald, so dumb he went exploring for gas by drilling in a gas tank. What do you say to that?
I said, in a can of beans.
Uh-huh. All right. And you, sir, what did you say?
Well, I'd like the judges to keep an open mind. I said a filling station.
Uh-huh.
Excuse me, judge. Judge, this is for you.
You know why
they had their big gas...
That's right, they have big gas tanks there. But the thing is, though...
She didn't say which gas tank.
Well, she did qualify her answer. She said in a car. I mean, you
no,
did
she didn't say a car.
No, I never heard you say that. Yeah. I said car, Gene.
Yeah, well, whatever. Anyway,
I spoke for her.
The judge did not
Rolling
match. What
right
do you say?
Along. I want you to keep an open mind, darlings, and remember later.
Okay, so there you are, Robin. See how it goes now? See how easy it is? Nothing to it, is there? Oh. Now we've got a little message for you, then you hurry right back. All right, let's go on now with the rest of round one. Susan, this is yours. Walter said, I think the stork that delivered our baby used to deliver pizzas. When he brought our baby, it was covered with blank. Simple question, right?
Yeah.
Good.
So That's many good answers.
Well, do
so
one.
There are about three.
Do what you think. Do what you think is best. Right.
Yes, that's what I think is very good.
Okay. Think about it for a second now, Susan. Now, are you writing, Charles? Yeah, here we go, Susan. Walter said, I think the stork that delivered our baby used to deliver pizzas. When he brought our baby, it was covered with...
Mozzarella cheese.
Mozzarella cheese. They put that on all of them, don't they?
Think so.
Yeah. That's the stuff when you take your fork and you put it in there, and it makes a long string about it. And then it gets all over you. Then, oh, it's a mess.
There's so many good answers, John.
Let me have a pizza. Hold the mozzarella, will you?
Yeah. So many good answers, depending on one's taste.
Right.
Thank you, Charles. Good for the room.
Yeah, that's right. It's a hard audience.
Salsa tomato. Salsa tomato, he says. What do you say?
I say, I'm all tuckered out. I'm going to go home and get in my bed.
Well, I'm sorry.
But I said cheese anyway.
Cheese. Okay.
The thing I hate worst, anchovies.
Anchovies, yeah. One pizza, holy anchovies for Charles. What do you say,
Charles, Elaine? Always writes down what I write down, and he finishes after me, so I think he's just...
When he brought our baby,
here.
It was covered with...
Anchovies.
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 What is the full question?
The full question, Walter,
just walked in from the kitchen. And
have you just walked in from the kitchen?
Yeah.
The full question reads as follows.
Right.
Are you with me? Yeah. Now, don't go back in the kitchen. Till I tell you to. Walter said, I think the stork that delivered our baby used to deliver pizzas, because when he brought our baby, it was covered with... And she said cheese.
So did I.
Oh.
Her.
What did you say?
I say the stork that delivered Brett was drunk. He was pitiful. No. I unfortunately said tomato sauce.
Tomato sauce. Okay, so we have two for you. And now we go to round two, and we'll see how you do with A or B.
It's B.
B it is for Robin Daytree. When Henry opened his fortune cookie, it said, you will meet a woman with long, dark hair. Unfortunately, it will be on her blank. Or brink. Unfortunately, it'll be on her brink. Oh, you clever. You Chinese lady, very clever. Yeah.
I hope it's right.
All right.
There aren't many around.
No, there aren't. Now, here we go with Robin Daytree. Robin, when Henry opened his fortune cookie, it said, you will meet a woman with long, dark hair. Unfortunately, it will be on her blank.
Her back?
Her back. Really?
Really?
I don't quite understand that, but that's what she said, her back.
She said that.
She said that, yes.
This is her last chance to catch up, and she said that?
That's what she said, yeah.
Intelligent looking woman.
Yes, she is.
Dumb answer.
Right.
On her chin.
On her chin. Okay.
Chin?
Chin.
I said on her chest.
This chest is good.
Or the region, which would be her chest if she were a man.
Okay. We do understand. Thank you for the clarification.
Sometimes, you know, if they don't get it right.
Right. What did you say?
Now that that one act play is over, chin.
So we have two chins and one chest. Chest would seem to me to be the definitive answer. A woman with long, dark hair is the lady you'll meet in this, according to Fortune Cookie. Unfortunately, the long, dark hair will be on her...
She got that from eating in Chinese restaurants. On her chest.
On her chest. Now, you must match the two remaining ones, Robin, to achieve a tie here and at least stay in the game. What do you say, Rich?
Chest.
Chest. That means Susan Stewart wins the game. And another chest. Okay. You know where to go. Go to your spot. Did you think of chest at all?
Boobs.
Hairy chest and all that thing. Well, Robin, we've got some gifts for you as a memento of your trip here to Match Game 77.
Thank you, I enjoyed
Robin Daytree. Okay. All right. What was that?
That was easy.
Yeah, it's almost by default, wasn't it? You have a total of $700 now. You picked up an additional $100 for winning this game here. And before we do anything here, Susan, we've got to do a little business with America. If you're ready for a little business with America, okay, let's have a little business with America. Now, here we are, and there we go. Listen, it's been just splendid having you here with us all week long.
I've loved it.
Oh, you're just saying.
No, we're in sync with the week again. This is Friday, right? Yes, it is a Friday.
It must be Bellevue.
If it's Friday, we must be in Belgium, right? Is there a parting shot that anyone would like to take at me?
Yes.
You've been wonderful.
Thank you. So have you, my dear.
I'd like to tell the audience that this Wednesday, this coming Wednesday, I'm on Beretta.
Oh. You are?
Yes.
Oh, everybody watch Scoy Mitchell on Beretta. Next time we get together, these are the people you'll see. Pay attention.
Hardy Johnson. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reddy. Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch.
I'm the former Gene Rayburn, and I hope you'll join us next time on Match Game 77. Goodbye.